friends, Laurie and Witch here with your monthly tarot card reading for your individual sign. This will be a brief snapshot of what's to come for most of you in your sun sign. It's also applicable for your rising sign and your moon sign. So watch those videos if you'd like a fuller picture of what seems to be coming up for you this month. I have picked up on messages the cards wish to give me for those who need to hear it. Now, it doesn't matter if you don't feel that you have a resonance with the messages, that's absolutely fine. Perhaps the messages this month don't really apply to you. Or you could, in fact, look back on the month and actually see that they did have a purpose there. So whatever you feel like in these messages, don't worry. I do hope it does resonate with a fair few of you. It seems like it's going to be a majority for this month. And if you'd like me to look at something more in depth with you, please feel free to get in touch. You can book and purchase a personal reading with me on both my website and through Etsy. As usual, thank you so much for your kind comments, for your sharing, subscribing, and also your emails as well. I've met a lot of you through Facebook and Twitter, in addition to YouTube, and this really makes me happy connecting with you all. So I just wanted to let you know I am so glad that I'm able to connect with you this way, and that a lot of you do feel a resonance with the readings that I do for you. So without further ado, let's have a look at your sign's monthly reading. Howdy doody Pisces, welcome to your September reading. It's a very interesting looking reading. I'm using the Chrysalis tarot deck. It's based loosely around the old tarot, but I do think they're trying to reinvent it mostly. It's been calling to me to use it for quite some time, so I thought why not try for the September, being a bit of a shake-up in any case, so we may as well have a look. The Oracle card is the Earth Oracle deck by Earth Magic Oracle deck, sorry, by Stephen D. Farmer. So let me have a look and see what September is bringing for you. As far as I can tell, you have a lot of exploration and okay. So the main feeling that I'm getting here is a lot of transformation, because we're now going into the case of the Saturn changing signs. Now this can really be a case of heave and ho. So whereas one area of your life is going to be kind of lifted, the other area is going to be magnified and have like a little, well actually microscope on it, looking at the finer details, the discipline of it, whether you've been meeting your needs and whether you need to fix anything. And that is, I think, already starting for you, to be honest, Pisces. The Four of Scrolls here in this tarot deck, scrolls means swords, just to give you kind of a little bit of information about that. But I do feel that it's almost like in the Four of Scrolls, in the first week of September, you're kind of setting your energy, you're reserving your energy. There's a transformation here, because you can see by the rainbow wings of the fairies kind of slumber, it's almost like with this rejuvenation and with this rest, you're kind of going to wake up feeling refreshed, you're going to be able to push forwards. I do feel that it's just drawing your energies close. Experience a time of feeling silent, and don't do anything overexertive in this week. Don't do anything that makes you feel like you're rushing around, losing your head, you know, that kind of thing. Just try and be, because I do feel that September is going to be such a difficult month for a lot of people around you, or certainly changes are going to be ridiculous in some cases. So I do feel that there will need to be a change. There will need to be some energy to go through with some of the plans that you make later on in the month, not necessarily at the start. But just skipping ahead a few weeks for you, the Four of Scrolls and the Eight of Spirals, which is the Eight of Wands, totally different. You got the Four of Scrolls, rest, rejuvenation, looking back on what you know, almost like a revision. You kind of have to go back over what you've learnt over these last few years while Saturn has been in Scorpio. Look at what you've actually taken from the experiences and the life lessons. Make any notes if necessary. Say, right, I don't want to repeat these mistakes again. And just kind of put that knowledge to bed. You know, it's kind of, okay, that's done. Let me reserve my energy. Because in the second week as well, you've got illumination. And whereas the moon normally means confusion and slight uncertainty about which direction to go in this deck I would interpret this as being almost the sole source of light to those who feel like they're a lost cause or feel like they're not sure which direction to go into. But here we have the solitary man on a solitary island looking up to the only source of light in the evening to illuminate the darkness. And I do feel that you are going to be the moon to a lot of people. You seem to be somebody who can reach out and connect with people on a higher plane and also on the inner realms as well. So I do feel that this is going to be you. You're not going to be illuminated necessarily. You're going to be the one doing the illumination. And you are going to find, I would say, that a lot of people gain clarity from speaking to you. And in speaking to others, you are going to gain a certain amount of clarity about yourself. This is very good for the next week as well, in the Three of Scrolls, because this represents a kind of rejection. So it's a Three of Swords, but I would say that this is, I think maybe some of your plans didn't go as you expected, and this is when Saturn moves signs. Because of this big shift, I think once the emotional trauma or, you know, the kind of heavy energy that can make sensitive Pisces very downtrodden, I think once that's just gone and once that's passed, it's actually going to be better for you. So even though the transition is going to be kind of heavy and it may actually make you miss some of the elements that were really good when Saturn was in Scorpio, the change is always about letting go of something, and it can be really hard because I do feel you are going to change into somebody different over these next few years. I would also say that, at least for me, you, Pisces in general, are one of the most complicated to understand. And I'm a water sign too. I'm a Scorpio. I don't know whether any of you know that. But sometimes you display an air quality of intelligence. Other times you display the fire sign quality of a sharp tongue or just not thinking what you're saying. Other times you show deep wisdom, which is normally the water signs as well. Other times you show a groundedness and a stubbornness and a practicality of the earth. So Pisces, it depends really as to what elements you have in your chart as to how you're going to take this for this third week. But I do feel for the most of you, you're going to be, they're saying kind of don't cry over spilt milk. It has to change. You have to transform. You have to become your real self. Because I feel like once this change happens, the Eight of Spirals, which is the Eight of Wands, you're going to be rushed off your feet. You are going to have such an injection of energy. You should feel now really strong. This is answers. You're going to get answers to questions maybe you never even asked. And it's all about swift progress and just, I mean, I know, you know, it can take, it looks like he's almost in a forest fire, and I know that that has been happening in America right now. It's been really stressful and awful, and all that earth being scorched there, and the families being moved, and, but this, I think it's the wrong image, if I'm perfectly honest, for the energy that I'm getting from it, and the message that I'm getting from it. It's rapid progress here, and I know they intended these kind of spirals to be almost like shooting stars, but to me I get kind of like asteroids. And you know what was that one, is it the Perseids asteroids or whatever it was coming to Earth and having the little space show for everybody? I would say that you are going to be highly psychic. Sorry, I was just trying to get the right words. You're going to get highly intuitive. You're going to get answers, again, to questions you may not have even asked. You're going to have a lot of things happening for you, around you, to other people. You're going to be directly involved. So the first 3 weeks of September seem to be mustering your energy, establishing yourself with other people, and giving that illumination and letting something go. And then it's kind of all hands on deck. Let's get into October. Let's kind of mush forward. Let's kind of do this. Spiritual energy is going to be on a high. You're going to be wandering around everywhere. But at the core of it, with this love and compassion card, you are going to be reaching out to others. And I do feel that this is the core of your September. You're going to feel love. You're going to feel both it from ancestral love, spirit guides, angels, whoever you work with. You're going to feel that connection. Really get the sense that it's something that means more than just the material world. This is something that's transformative into the universe as well. So whatever you've put in to Scorpio over the last 3 years when Saturn was in there, it's going to reward you. And I feel some of you may have gone or just gone through your Saturn return. So if you're about 30, 31, or is it 60, maybe 60, 61, you know, if you've gone through either of those transformative times, you're going to get kind of a reward for that. And it fits, because Scorpio's the sign of transformation, and you're going to go through one in September. It may be small, but it's still a transformation, and that's why it's kind of a disruptive to your psychic energies. Nothing to be feared. Scorpios do get scared, but, you know, they kind of just go into the dark depths, and anything weird and taboo and kind of unexplored, kind of like Pluto, its ruling planet, that's going to be, you know, you've probably experienced a fair bit of that over the last few years. So this is going to be very strong, this is going to be very illuminating, and you're going to transform through the lessons into something a lot better for you. And I'm really looking forward to seeing what October brings, because I do feel it's going to be this Eight of Spirals energy is going to be leading you into October in a very strong way. If you'd like me to look into anything in depth or more personally for you, my website's below. It's very simple to purchase a reading from me. Or if you want something more custom made for you, just email me at the address below and we'll be able to work something and arrange something for you. My Etsy shop at the moment is on holiday. I have a lot of personal deadlines, writing deadlines to meet. So that's why that has actually gone on holiday. But I am still absolutely available to help anybody who may need a personal reading. In the meantime, do enjoy your September. Don't worry about this transformative energy that's coming through. You will have people, you will have the love and compassion of people to reach out for and to actually give. So it's not going to be too bad. And in the meantime as well, I would love to hear any comments that you have as to how it's going. But take care of yourself, and I will read for you in October.